Hello guys, welcome to a new series here on the channel. My name is Dashlip, and today I'm starting a single player survival series in a new Minecraft 1.14 pre-release 2, right up here at the top that you can see. We are in a vanilla snapshot of 1.14. Reddit has decided that this probably is not very good for a server, but for single player, if you want to hop in, you know, not too bad. So I'm probably going to stick with pre-release 2 at the unless there's a lot of bug fixes in 3 or 4 until the full 1.14 release, just to stay safe. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to the series, guys. Let's do some starter things, I guess, this episode, and talk about what the purpose of a single player series is. So in this series, I want to take Minecraft survival building to the next level. In single player, that is, I'm gonna be all alone, be doing things my own way, however I want to do them. Now I am still a part of the NSG server, and yes, we will be doing a map reset whenever 1.14 fully releases. So I'm very excited about that, and I'm also going to possibly be a part of another SMP, but that is kept under lid currently, so I don't want to really talk too much about that. Nevertheless, I think this is going to be very fun, and it's something that will last longer than probably either of the worlds on the SMPs that I will be joining, because I do not fancy a world reset personally. So when 1.15 comes out, I won't do a world reset. More than likely, I will just go out and adventure and, you know, find new things and keep with whatever I'm doing. So that's fine. Let's go ahead and replant that. Got some wood here. I'm just gonna do, you know, basic Minecraft things. Also, if you're looking at the font or the grass color over there in the plains, I've got a little custom texture pack on. It's just the default textures, the new default textures that are already in the game for 1.14, except I've added a font and the grass color is a little bit more green in places that it wouldn't be, like savannas and mountain biomes and plains. It really all matches the forest green, is what it's closest to. But yeah, really looking forward to this series. I'm gonna have a ton of fun. I think I don't exactly know what I want to do, what I want to build first. Maybe we should go out and find a village of sorts. It won't be building anything more than likely in this first episode. Just gonna be getting some things sorted out, you know, like materials and stuff like that. You know, getting some armor and some diamonds, maybe, hopefully by the end of the episode. But we may just, you know, build up a little area here at spawn, or we may go find a village, first thing next episode and start working there, since this is update is all about villages. Alright, a nice cave that we can explore. I do want to find some food first, so we got a taiga nearby. That's nice. Not completely random seed, but I haven't really looked around this world. I have a friend named TC Midnight who actually put this seed in a discussion that I was in earlier, and I just flew around it for a second and checked it out. You know, I saw this forest biome, I saw the plains biome over there. I think there's dark oak somewhere nearby, and you know, the beautiful ocean right there. And I was like, you know what, this is good enough for me. I don't really need to look around too much. But yeah, I'm gonna enjoy my time here on this world, and I hope you guys will too. So I'm gonna go out and find some food and, you know, slaughter some cows, and then I'll be back. Alright, I am over in the plains biome searching things out. We've got some pretty horses. There's a set of tan ones over there. I just tried to zoom in, but no Optifine. I got killed 3 sheep for 3 wool. We got some pigs, a couple cows, some chickens. I'm going to go on ahead and slaughter the chickens. I'm not going to slaughter any more sheep than I have to. Obviously not going to kill any horses. Don't need the leather for anything really right now. Not going to waste time with leather armor. But I do want to go get down into a cave here pretty soon. So I'm just going to run around, gather up a little bit more food, and then we'll head back to the cave that we found over there. Little bit of surface coal on top of a mountain never hurt anybody. Gonna grab this so I can smelt up our food real quick. Just thought I'd, you know, do little short progress updates throughout the video of what I am doing, since really this episode is just me getting geared up, and then we'll do building and stuff like that, really starting next episode. Yes, we have donkeys. That's a plus. And it occurred to me I never really showed the seed earlier, so there it is if you guys would like to play on this world. Just walking around, there's the dark oak, birch forest, mountains. We saw a taiga earlier in an earlier clip, so really there's a lot of biodiversity. Spawn in a forest with an ocean and plains right here. This is a beautiful, beautiful seed. So thank you, TC Midnight, for sharing it. And we have arrived back at our first little cave that we found earlier. Where was it at? Right over here. Just in time for night. So I'm going to craft a bed, seal us in here, and we are going to sleep away the night and do a little bit of caving. Ah, yes, our first mob. The entrance to the cave is just right there. I've got some food going, but we have our first little creeper. Alright, and... oh! I suck. It's been too long. Oh, wow. Broke into another part of the cave. Well, I guess we would have known anyways, I imagine. Oh, chance to redeem myself. There we go. Alright. Been too accustomed to just two or three hitting creepers with a nice enchanted diamond sword. Let's get this guy. Come on. Really? There we go. Got him. And our first few pieces of iron as well. I'm gonna run this stuff back up and smelt it. I just killed an Enderman and he dropped an Enderpearl and a grass block. That's weird. Alright, gonna craft us up some armor now. This is the best way to make armor. You can make all three of those at the same time if you do it like that. Put this on. We can make ourselves a better pickaxe, a better sword, the last stick. And we will save these for later, I guess. Gonna sleep again, and this cave is all done, so I'm gonna go find another cave, do a bunch of caving, get a bunch of resources, and then I'll come back after all of that and catch you guys up. I have finished caving. I have got a ton of materials, as well as diamond pickaxe, a few extra diamonds, and obsidian for a portal and enchant table. And we are back up, and I have installed a 1.14 version of Faithful. You can tell that it's 1.14 and the textures are actually updated. I'm editing right now and I just noticed these blue flowers. What are they? Anyways, because of these right here specifically, the leaves are changed and the wood, as well as right here on the sword, these pixels are darker and they didn't used to be this dark. But they were changed by Yappa for the actual default textures, and now this is updated for Faithful. So yeah, looking really nice. Now I'm gonna do some other work, kind of get a little mini base operation set. I'm gonna try and do some research and find out if there's an AFK fish farm that works for 1.14 yet, and then I will bring you guys back. All right, I was just looking up a video, and then I turn around and this guy shows up. Wandering trader. This must be a new thing. He's got to trade for blue eyes, orange dye. Yeah, this is really cool. He's got a couple llamas right here. Nothing I can really do with him right now because I don't have any emeralds, but really, really cool. And I wanted to show off the textures for this guy. And yes, it is updated for Faithful. So yeah, looks very, very nice. Really like that texture. Oh my god, this is so insanely stupid. This is a fish farm right here, okay? A fence, a pressure plate, a note block, a trapdoor, and a hopper. This is a fish farm in 1.14. Mojang thought that they removed them? No. This is a fish farm now. Jesus. You just aim right there and hold down right click. This is your AFK fish farm. Wow.
And as the sun sets on this Minecraft day, so does the sunset on our first episode here on our 1.14 survival single player series. I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. I am going to, in between this episode and next episode, AFK fish farm a bunch and try and give you guys a you know, a good result for how this stupidly simple farm operates. And tomorrow, which is Tuesday the 23rd, is when Mojang should, quote me, should be releasing 1.14. So I want to get this episode out just in time for the actual release of 1.14. So that's all I have time for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I want you to comment down below if you made it this far, and let me know what you want to see from me in this series. Do you want me to go out and find a village and improve that village? Should I stay here and build up a little area at spawn and then go out and do that? What do you want to see from me? Whatever you guys think I should do, I will definitely consider doing. So, again, thank you so much.